Hello, Gemini. This is your extended reading. So this extended is coming through with a lot of messages of, coming full circle, of finding the point of conclusion, of reaching your mission, of finding that your heart really truly guided you to the right place, and you knew it inside yourself, inside your heart, that there was this just this knowing, this clear feeling in you that was, always moving you. It's like this desire to go, this desire to fly, because it is part of who you are. And being who you are, fulfilling your destiny, it's also part of unlocking the magic that lives within you, which is so gorgeous, because I feel like that is going to surprise you in so many ways, Gemini, that I feel like you are not anticipating how big this daring to fly is for you, because really for you it can start with something very simple, as a nudge, like this impulse, which, if we think of, the pulses of the heart, this is what gives you the impulse to move, right? And this impulse is what is instead of keeping you settled, in this place that provided you safety, or at least, the familiar grounds, that you found enough abundance that you, it's like this, if you think of a safe place, this is the place that you would think of, right? And this is the place that perhaps it's it costs you a lot, right? Perhaps not financially, but it costs you a lot to leave it, right? To, because it is something that you have to dare to come out of it, right? But knowing that not only your heart is telling you that you need to fly off, right, to find your own freedom, to find your own independence, like your intuition is on point, because you know that wherever you are, Gemini, even if it is really far away from the place that you left, it is, there is also, this intuitive link, which is coming through as the moonlight, right? When the moonlight is, just shining through the dark, it's like, that it's the same moon that is lighting the place that you left and the place there that you are, and, the many places that you are still supposed to go. So I feel like there is a dynamic here talking about cycles, and it's interesting because I feel like San talked about this dynamic between night and day. I don't know if it was in her last video or not, but I feel like this is something that is showing up here. And the message is, well, mainly the guidance here right at the end of this reading, and we'll get into the cards, but just to give you this overview that I like to give, it's like, don't worry about how the cycles are moving, because it's almost like you are intrinsically connected to this dynamic, right? If you allow yourself to fly away, right, from the place that you grew up in, or that it's so familiar to you and so cozy and so comfortable, and it's abundant in itself, right? But there is more abundance to be found elsewhere, and not only abundance that is physical, right? Because we have, from the first part, the Nine of Pentacles and the Empress, but here, because we have so many beautiful cards, it's talking about finding abundance in happiness, in this state of awareness, in the state of illumination that you will find yourself once you fly off, once you it's like you need to take off, you need to take this risk, to take this leap into something that your heart is already pointing. So your heart is pointing towards this here, right? Which, this Three of Cups to me always brings this co-creation word with it, which is something that is, the water realm. So it's like this potential that is swimming around you. It's like being surrounded by this puddle of love, in a sense. It's what I'm just hearing, but it's like you are in a pool that you know that you're being guided because of this current, right? It's almost like this undercurrent, especially because we have the Ace of Swords, and this Ace of Swords is obviously coming through, you know, as truth. So the co-creation of truth, which is this being taken by the undercurrent, right? And it's interesting how, you know, the image of being inside a puddle or being inside a pool, they are so different, because perhaps where you were or where you still are, if you haven't, you know, taken off already, it's like it feels like a puddle in comparison to this pool that can be very, well, can be very overwhelming, right? If this is coming through as this potential, right? It's something that is yet to take shape, yet to take form, but it's being guided by the undercurrent of truth. It's like, allow yourself to be taken from the puddle, you know, through this stream of water, which is actually coming through as now stream of consciousness and awareness to the heart, awareness to the truth, which is like they are one and the same, right? The awareness of your heart is also, and always, as I'm hearing now, is always linked to truth, the truth that beats inside your heart. This is the undercurrent. The undercurrent is the impulse that pulses because you are listening to your heart, right? And this is actually leading you towards this, well, now sea of consciousness, right? Because we have the Three of Wands. And so, which is interesting, right? If the place that you came from is very well established, is very secure, very safe, perhaps a very, you know, beautiful house, just a place that you felt protected within it, right? And perhaps it has like this feature or this one element that you are more attached to, right? Perhaps a tree, like I was to my tree. If you've known anything about, you know, Mrs. Y's tree story. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go to the video where I thanked Sen when she gave me the shout out. I think its name is Thank You for Being Here With Me. I tell the story about Mrs. Y's tree, but nonetheless, it can be a tree or it can be anything else, right? Just this element that brings you this safety memory, the place that reminds you, or the object that reminds you of the your roots, right? Of how safe you felt there. And so here, because we're, you know, this puddle of love is leading you towards this sea of consciousness through this stream of awareness, the stream of truth, because you are being led by the impulses, right, of the heart, is leading towards the multiplication of whatever felt already so very abundant, right? If you left a place that felt safe, secure, abundant, right? You know, taking a risk and daring to go out of this place can feel very risky, can feel very scary. But if you know that you're being guided, right, as we saw the Knight of Cups, that everything that you need will be provided, but you have to open your arms, you have to open your wings and fly. It's like, know that not only you will find, you know, a similar abundance to what you have already experienced, but it's going to multiply. It's like the co-creation that comes from the heart, it's going to manifest itself through this sea of truth, through this following the undercurrent of truth, right, into something that is this potential to multiply what you already had at home, in a sense, right? But threefold, right? So it's like multiplying by three, something that already brought you safety, security, and it's something that is pointing directly to the fulfillment of your destiny, right? So we have the three going to the one, and the three again into the Wheel of Fortune. So what this is talking about, all of this, you know, it's, I'm seeing it like a continuous flux of water and energy and truth, right? Leaving the puddle of love, right? Perhaps this safe place, right? Perhaps this tree, the family tree, right? Being the one that flew off, but also being the one who dared to fulfill your own destiny, that perhaps it is as abundant, right? The potential for abundance, it is still there. It is coming from the roots that you still carry with you, but not with the image of the same sense of fixedness, something being fixed, right? Or and immovable, because the three to me, and actually because also of the wings, right? The movement of the wings flying, it's also so free, like the movement is so free that even though you are carrying the roots, right? You're carrying these wings, the wings actually are carrying you, but they're made of the leaves that you plucked from the tree, right? So some elements of the place that you left are still there, but you have your own unique destiny that is going to, it's like, it's going to, it's almost like I'm seeing, like, from all of the movement of the undercurrent, it's like there is one that is made specifically for you, Gemini, as if it's like this slide, right? But it's this slide that is perfect for you, and it holds the potential because you are holding the roots. So it's almost like the pattern in your DNA is what is going to configure the way that this potential here is going to be manifested through truth, right? In order to fulfill your own destiny, if it makes any sense. Sometimes when I channel these things and I, you know, listen again, I'm just like amazed by things that come out of my mouth, because sometimes I really do not, I completely, you know, just my mind goes blank. When I finish these readings, I really cannot remember what I just said, but let's keep on going. So after you find that from within the sea of potential that you find yourself now, right? Because you left the puddle of love, and by following this, it's almost like this natural instinct, right? The impulse that is beating from your heart, and allowing truth to guide you like this undercurrent into, it's like going straight to the arms of your destiny in a sense, right? This is what comes next, the Magician and the Ten of Cups. So this is what I'm talking about, not only, you know, all of the potential that you hold within that is there for you to co-create, like, it's like you hold within you all of the seeds of things that want to be manifested, right? Because today the wands are coming through as more like this earthy image because of the trees. So it's like bringing whatever is a potential in this sea of consciousness, right, that is beating through your heart and being manifested through something that has a connection to your past but is unique to you, right? And it's unique because you are starting to know how to do it. It's like through listening to your heart, right? Being this Knight of Cups, Gemini, and starting this extended with the Three of Cups, is like whatever needs to come through your co-creation, your unique path of co-creation, it's like you're ready now to manifest this tenfold of love. So this is all this image, right? All of these cards so far are talking about this movement between, you know, leaving this puddle of love. And I mean puddle, just, you know, the contrast between the size, right? It could be like a pond, right? It's just that it came through as a puddle, but perhaps just because it's very very shallow, who knows? Or it's something that depends on the cycles of the rain, perhaps. But it doesn't matter really. It's just, you know, the way that it came through was puddle of love, right? Something that was restricted, or it was just fed when it rained, right? But this stream, right, that is led by truth, the truth of your heart, it's like this is giving you direction, right? It's giving you this knowingness that you have a mission to accomplish. You have this thing to co-create, because it's like this magician is coming through as development of your own manifesting abilities, of your own magic tricks, of your own magic powers, and how this is, you know, unlocking such power of love. It's like this Ten of Cups is coming through as whatever you thought was something small or just a nudge, right, or just a small intuition. It's like, it's such a part of who you are and who you came to be and what you came here to accomplish, that it's almost like you are learning to play your part, to play your role to such, it's just to such perfection, to such brilliant capability that I feel like you are going to be surprised by how much you are able to co-create when you listen to your heart, right? Which feels so cheesy, but also feels so true, right? And it gets better because we have these two cards that actually came together, two major arcana, the Sun and the Death card. And before you freak out with the Death card, because it's the card that it's ending, it's actually, you know, not the last card, because I'm also going to include the bottom of the deck. But before we get there, this card is actually talking about going to sleep, right, when the sun goes down. So this is, you know, emphasizing the dynamic of the cycles, right? When I talked in the first part about the cycles of, you know, the sun, the moon and the sun, and how, you know, Sen talked about it in her Capricorn reading, perhaps, or the Sagittarius one. I don't remember if it was in the extended or on the YouTube portion, but I'm pretty sure she talked about it and how it's like she was questioning how much value the darkness holds, right? Do we really need to have this dual perspective of, you know, nighttime and daytime? Or could we live in a forever, you know, daytime, right? Like fully illuminated, completely illuminated, you know, 100% of the time. I'm not sure. I really have to give it, you know, a second and third and fourth thought about it. But I was just, you know, amazed by how time is this perception of, you know, being awake and being asleep. Because this is when you feel like you see something growing, you see time passing by. And this is the dynamic that, you know, we feel, right, with night and day, which is so clearly being expressed here, especially because these two cards are talking about, you know, your active life and your passive life, right? This death is coming through as sleeping. So when you're asleep, it's like your body is resting, right? And when you are awake, you are very active, you are moving, you are constantly moving. And so this is perhaps part of this, well, this, you know, finding your unique power is something that has been coming through, you know, very powerfully in the last two or three readings, I guess. Yeah, I think it was, you know, coming through very potently for Aries and for Taurus, and it's also here for you, Gemini, but in a way that I feel like you need to take the leap of, you know, risking flying away from the place that you lived your entire life and find your own independence. When you feel like you have found it, it's like you're going to find how you can really manifest this abundance that is not only physical, right, to support yourself, but it's also emotional, it's internal, it's external with the Nine of Pentacles from the first part, but it's also internal, right, with this Ten of Cups. And this is what is this continuous development, right? It's like whatever you found yourself capable of doing, capable of achieving, right, of manifesting your life, it's like it is a continual and dynamic duel between being active and being passive, right? It's like doing things and resting, right? This is coming through as like, this is the necessary dynamic in order for you to come full circle, actually, which is coming through here at the bottom of the deck. So we have the Emperor at the bottom of the deck, which is obviously talking about how spreading the wings in the first part is actually allowing you to complete this cycle, right? Another time we're talking about cycles, right? So for this cycle in specific to come to a conclusion, to come full circle, right? For you to rest your wings, it's like first you need to spread them and fly, right? You need to open your arms and fly away from the place that you're used to, right? Because in finding so, you are going to reach not only what is written for you in a sense, right? It's like you're also going to find a way to manifest the life that you can also find fulfillment in every sense of the word, right? And know that there will be times where you will be active like you are in the daytime, but also times where you are passive. Like, well, I'm not going to use that word. I'm going to use more receptive, right? Because if we think of nighttime when we dream, it's like there is a lot of internal and subconscious work going on. It's just not the same work that we do when our body is awake, right? This is more like the subconscious part of ourselves is awake, but our body is asleep, right? So coming full circle is part of this process. It's like there is going to come a time when you will find, you know, freedom in spreading your wings and fly, and then realizing that you can settle down in a sense, right? Because, you know, if we think of the, if we think of the Ten of Cups as, you know, family, right? This is also coming through as, you know, the roots that are, that you found safety when you left your home family or, you know, whoever you left behind, right, in this place. It's like you're going to find fulfillment again, whether you're back to this place or not, which perhaps you could come back. I'm not seeing anything that is actually, you know, directing me to coming back, but you could, right? So Gemini, let's see what the astrological runes have to add as a final guidance for you. Okay, so we have the Ascendant here and Sagittarius, but I was laughing because it was actually like this. The Sagittarius was pointing towards the Ascendant. So what this is pointing actually towards is that no matter what impulse is making you take this risk and take this leap, right? If we think of Sagittarius as the sign that is the adventurer, is the explorer, is the traveler, right? They are always, you know, on the go in a sense. They are always ready for the next trip, for the next journey. It's like they are excited to go, right? But also the Ascendant is talking to me about this freedom of being yourself, right? The Ascendant talks about your personality. So it's like you need to find the independence in being who you are, even though it requires leaving where you are, right? This is pretty clear to me, Gemini. I hope this was insightful for you. Thank you so much for being here with me, and I'll see you next time. Okay, bye.